Hi, my name is Shadi Atia, Assistant Professor of Sustainable Architecture and Building Technology at Liège University in Belgium. I'm going to talk to you today about the study conceptual framework, which is an important element in any research methodology. Well, the audience of my presentation is early career researchers who are preparing a research thesis, dissertation, or a journal publication. And in this sense, I would talk about what is a conceptual framework or what is a study conceptual framework and how to create one. Well, what is a study conceptual framework? A study conceptual framework says what is your research methodology simply. So it answers two main questions. What is the research approach and methodology used in this work? And how was data collected, analyzed, and applied? Well, a study conceptual framework contains sufficient information to allow other researchers to adopt or replicate your methodology. So it has to be clear, transparent, and structured and logical, corresponding to the best practices of doing research. Well, identification. What is the study conceptual framework also? It looks at the identification of key concepts and relationship among your methodology. So it's very important what are the steps you did in your methodology, and it is kind of abstract and logical structure that guide the development of the study. So it is a visual illustration of your research methodology, and therefore it's very important for your research. Well, this is an example for a study conceptual framework. As you can see on the left side, this is the textual description of the methodology or material and methods. But in the same time, instead of presenting it in a textual way, you have also to create a visual graphic that simplifies your methodology. And this is a very simple study conceptual framework where we can see the main three activities that were done methodologically in this research. For sure, you can have a more detailed study conceptual framework where you go more into detail and you define more sub-activities that were taking place. Between a simple and a complex, it is up to you to decide which one you select, but it is crucial to have one study conceptual framework at the beginning of your introduction description of your methodology in whatever document you have, whether it's a thesis, a dissertation, or a publication. Now, how to create a study conceptual framework? It's very simple. You have to define the methodological key steps that took place during your research. And you have to look at the classical research approach that most researchers use, which is always data collection, data processing, instrument development, and application. Those are the four major steps. Make sure that your study conceptual framework corresponds to those or even goes beyond them, but at least you must address those four or include them, embed them in your framework. Are the steps of your research linked? Are they following each other? Are they going into parallel? These are questions to be answered. You need also to answer this question. Do you need some elements to develop or complete a key step of your methodology? And you have to find the element linking one key step to another. So those are the four questions that need to be answered within the context of your methodology. Well, use arrows to show the links and make sure that every step in your research is related to another step, seeking the beginning with data collection till the testing or validation of your research findings. This is an example for a very simple study research framework. This is a paper where the researcher is trying to develop a climate analysis tool. In order to develop this climate analysis tool, there was a literature review that was done, followed by a climate analysis and a comfort estimation in parallel. This activity or this research activity, those three research activities, were feeding the development of the tool, and finally, from down to up, there was a process of tool validation. Now, this is the logic of a study framework where you make sure that you show that you did a data collection, you did a data processing, you did a development of something new, a tool, a method, or others, and finally, you validated what you created. So it has to be always clear in a study conceptual framework how the research respects the four criteria I mentioned earlier, and later on you can have some more detailed description to check and explain better how these activities were done. So as you can see, validation is very important to feed back to make sure that what is developed is tested and applied on a scale. This is also another example where in this research we try to develop a framework, and simply to develop the framework we did a literature review, we did a process mapping which fed the development, and finally we validated that through focus group discussions and interviews. So this is an example to explain very briefly how a research was done in a visual way, supported by sub-activities to explain to the reader or the reviewer what is this research about. Well, conclusion. The study conceptual framework is very important, and it's a visualization of your research methodology. So please start to work on it early on, and you can even start brainstorming with your supervisor or peer colleagues to make sure first on a sketch paper that it makes sense of your research. Always your study conceptual framework should be done before you do your research. Also, it's directed by key step and links between them, between the key steps of your research. It provides a logical and abstract structure of your methodology, and it makes readers better understand your research. So this is another example that you can see how the research was done, respecting always the four criteria of what was your data collection, how was your data collection, how was the data processed, what did you develop, and how did you test it or validate it. So it's very important to respect those four criteria, embed them in your graphs, and work on them. Finally, I would like to ask you to subscribe to the channel if you didn't do, to follow any future videos, and thank you for your attention. And by that, I end the presentation on the study conceptual framework. Thank you very much.